mechanic.
Have you started any recording yet?
No.
Well, here's the beginning of our trip, Friday the 13th. John's outdrive is.
There's Rick over there going up. Told you to roll.
Oh, I didn't have the camera on. So all that, I don't know what I said. Anyways, if I'm repeating myself, John's outdrive is off. I'll go back and show you. There it is. There's his outdrive. Here's his outdrive. I don't know if it's focused. Is it focusing by itself, George?
Yeah, yeah.
It is? Moving? Can you see it move?
If you want to do it, though.
George, is it moving right now?
No.
Okay, it's not focusing. Okay, Joe just took off. Larry Butler's fishing the channel outside waiting for us, and we should be catching up to them in about an hour. Artie and gang should be here about 1 o'clock. They'll be meeting us at the Marquesas. We're at Garrison Bite. Just waiting around. I'll give you a time on this. If I can find a button. Okay, there's Friday the 13th. And there's what time it is. All right, talk to you later.
There's a little, oh, it's still recording.
Well, as you can see by the time, we're doing good time. Got two ace mechanics working on it. John and Courtney.
Good at that.
Yeah. Okay, they're getting a place the odd drive on. They're probably going to need my help, so I'm going to have to shut this camera down. We could send this film to Mercruiser as a training film. All right, signing off.
Here's the job when we're all done. 10:24 in the morning.
No. I'm missing a few here.
We're here putting away the tools there. Fighting over
that one.
Who's
I like.
What's
the tool? Like a channel lock, line wire. There we go.
Look at that beautiful boat. That pretty lady right there. Are you having fun yet?
That's enough, George.
Are relaxing, reading the paper?
Hey, we're going out the channel right now. John has got his boat in the water and he's behind us a few minutes. What are you doing, Carol?
I put this time
I already had it on. You just shut it off. Okay. Watch where you're going, George. Green marker on your right. This is Garrison Bite Marina.
That's where we put in. Because I see the Amoco. That's the Amoco where we filled up last night.
The day is nice and warm, sunny. Seas are probably going to be 2 to 3 feet out there. We're going to meet up with Larry Butler, Joey, that are fishing already. They're just outside the harbor in Key West. And we got to go out this little cut over there. You like your new cushions?
My back cushions make it nice.
Yeah.
Yeah, you don't have to worry about falling over.
Kitty,
Fire and Ice
calling.
John should be coming out
okay,
there.
Okay, we on the way. Where yet?
We're waiting.
We're waiting coming out the channel on here.
Okay, 10-4. Going to the bridge?
Yeah, we blind on the bridge already. Oh, it's a funny flashing.
Where are they at?
They're coming. They'll be coming out right under that bridge there, but ask them when they're going to be at the bridge.
When are you going to be at the bridge?
Oh, you know when you transmit, it messes up the camera.
What, honey?
Don't transmit anymore, because every time you transmit, it throws the camera off.
Really? You're kidding. Why? It doesn't have to do
it. Well, it does, okay? Magnetic off the antenna. Look at that guy on the plane. The old fishing boats out there.
George, do you have to close one eye when you're filming?
Yeah, it helps.
Of course not. Why, you don't?
No, it's just, I just noticed it.
Okay, now we gotta go to the left, George. It's real shallow off of these markers, off on your right. And you have to go slow the whole way here.
Captain getting ready, putting on his contact lenses so he can see for the day. He'll be out momentarily. Yes, he will. Mom, why are you filming that? I didn't get a picture of him yet because he's still too far away. Yeah, I just did it. Yeah. What? What, honey? The fader's not on.
Comes John. It's kind of rocky, but you'll get an idea. So he's got balls to the wall. Well, I'm moving the camera like it's some of it, but it's tough. I'll make it come real fast. Here it comes. Oh, Jesus, it's coming too fast. It's gonna hit the boat. Well, they go. Never look back, Jensen. Larry Krakenoon Butler. John's leaving?
No. John's gone.
Where is John?
John's way over there.
Oh, shoot, he's way over there?
Yeah, he's way.
Dad, those guys left. There's like a little sunken boat over there. I think we should check it out.
Huh?
Can't even see him. He's so far.
You hear me, Dad?
Kind of bumpy still.
We're in the Marquesas fishing.
That's a nice one.
And there's a lot of action, as you can see, going on. I'll be bringing you in on more of the action here.
Are you rocking a boat, Karen?
Get that. Oh, yeah.
Got some more action over here. Zip. Bringing in a fish. We're not sure what it is.
It's a jack.
Oh, it's a jack. There's a lot of jack out here. Yeah. There's Joey. What's Joey gonna catch?
I'm not supposed to be out here.
Woo! Who's rocking the boat?
We got a big fish here.
All right. Good little lamb.
Nice yellowtail. This is what you do, see, Carol?
Mm-hmm.
You insert the hook through the meat side, hook it out through the skin side, check it drag for the big. Okay, see that? Find their slick line and cast it in.
Yeah, I think chumming really helps. Is John on his way yet? John wants to come where all the action is.
Let the line out. Watch my line. Focus on my line.
Oh, shit. Look at this.
Can you see John coming?
My hook's gone.
Oh. You guys see John coming yet?
Yeah, he's coming.
There he is. He's coming. What are you using for bait,
shrimp.
Georgie? Shrimp? Nice fish.
I think taught you all this stuff.
What?
He doesn't appreciate me.
He doesn't.
I taught him everything he knows, and he's catching more fish than I am.
Mom taught me how to do it.
Oh, let me see it. Let me see it, George. Yeah. That's not bad. Is that the way you do it? Oh, you threw it back.
Oh. He's the king of losing. Makes a nice here with these cushions here.
Here comes John. He's coming in on for some action. Let's see if we can see what time it is.
Mom, use that thing to watch.
Yeah.
Let's see you catch one on film. I figured it wouldn't take Greg this long to moon us. Go ahead.
Not something you want to take home.
That doesn't matter. Home is here.
Get a zoom lens.
Yeah, I got a macro lens for you.
That hurts.
Oh. Here comes John. John's gonna anchor up.
And here comes John moving in on the hot spot.
Well, you heard him.
He sees it, he's gonna anchor. Look out.
Tell him to come behind the slick.
It's hard keeping this camera steady, so people that are viewing this, please be, what's that word? Patient. Or understanding is a better word. Oh no, don't anchor there!
Well, the guys are trying to put their tents up to get ready for the night, and it's raining right now.
Let's try this.
Uh-oh. Oh. Oh. Loose.
It's a little rod.
Yay. A little rod. Gotta give it
the
time.
That's
a lane.
Walk the light.
Appreciate it.
Whoa, 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 whoa.
Sitting here.
Hey, Wesley.
You want the lane?
If he's legal, keep him. Find a damn button.
Coffee too hot? And the cold and the beer's too cold?
Coffee's too hot and the beer's too cold. Anybody want some Danish?
No, thanks.
Not too hot to take yet.
You want to put some ice in it?
No. I need to do it at home. I'm going to look.
Courtney, what's your son's name?
Hmm?
What's your son's name? Oh, you're sorry.
Angel.
Angel.
Who is Joe and where is he at?
Joe?
Another boat?
Yeah.
Oh, Joey?
Yeah, the Fagawi.
The Fagawi.
The guys you were talking to.
He's over by the beach with Artie, camping.
Well, Crack of Noon is leaving. And it's before the crack of noon. It's 8:12. And crack of noon is the party.
Takes a few minutes for it to adjust.
No.
Look at the...
Yep.
Okay, well, here we are. We caught up with Larry Butler. Hi, Greg. And we're all out here together. And about.
Keep the camera rolling because I'm going to get one here in a second.
Now. Okay, it's about.
Take care of that yellowtail because something's going to nail
62 feet of water here. And we're trying
we're
to catch some.
Rolling.
Trying to catch some yellowtail. So let's see if Larry is all he says he is today.
Oh!
Okay, let's see. We got some action going on here. I'll try to bring you a false alarm. Well,
I had one.
We'll be back shortly.
Yeah.
Bye for now. Well, George, what have you got? That's our first fish. It's not very big,
that's
but
that's the only thing he can catch. A little bandy fish.
That's all we got right now. What we have here is Larry's line is tangled in the lobster trap, and him and Greg are trying to get it out. I don't know, looks like I got a mess. Well, I think they got it. Let's go in here and see if we can get a little closer. It's a little rocky out here, so I apologize for all this motion. Motion of the ocean. Well, let's see what happens. Here's the lobster trap. Larry's still trying to get his line out. His line must have gone inside the lobster trap. Yeah. I think they'll manage. Let's see what else is in here. Is there anything in there? Oh, that fire's out. Yep, he's got to take the thing apart, it looks like.
Any lobsters? Mom, you taking it?
What you doing? Chum a little and see what we can get. It looks like they got some
big
time chum out there.
Big red.
Hey, Greg, get him! Don't lose your balance now. Spit the chew out.
Camera, got the camera.
Spit the chew out.
That hiney hole.
We got some action now.
Yeah, man. Yeah, yank him out the boat. Don't let him rest, Greg. Move to the front of the boat. Move to the front of the boat so you can shut your head out there.
Seems like we got some action here.
Oh yeah, get the gap. It's a 2-pound grunt.
Greg's got something on.
Oh.
He's losing his balance here.
You got the business in here, the business in.
Yeah.
Get the gap, get the gap. Oh, Wes got one.
Uh-oh. We got double action here.
The chum did it, man.
That was a chum.
Oh, too hard.
Uh-oh. Greg.
Shark.
Greg lost it.
Okay, it's my turn now.
Must have been that cuda. Well, here comes John. See what's going on over here. We still don't have much action.
You got some chum on your boat?
We'll see what happens here.
Now, you got that?
Well, let's see. Larry's got one on. It appears. Let's see if he can bring it in.
You don't
want
to come up.
Barracuda.
I think it might be a barracuda.
It might be a large garden variety type.
I don't think we're going to get to see it for some reason.
Keeper.
Got a keeper, Dad? Oh, good. We're going to have him for dinner, huh?
cool?
Sorry we missed it before, but Larry lost that fish he was fighting. And Greg was fighting something here, I don't know. What happened, Greg? As you can see, it's a beautiful day. Georgie had a bite, but he lost it. John back there fishing away. You can move in on John's hand back there. I don't know if he's catching anything or not. Whoa, here comes some waves.
Can't see it. Too far away. Oh, there, got it. That was it.
Okay, here we are at the military. What do we got here? Oh. Here we are at the military bombing. See, it says danger. And there's cobia down on the bottom, a school of cobia all over. So George and Georgie are got a live yellowtail on the end, and they're going to try to catch the cobia. They've already caught one. As you can see, there's a sunken ship. I think it's a sunken ship.
It's a barge.
Oh, a barge down on the bottom where the fish like to hang out.
It's really a target.
Target practice. And we're going to go over to the point where the cobia are hanging out, see what we can get. I'll keep you posted. Bye for now.
When they swallow it, you gotta really pull on that.
I catch the next what?
Cobia.
Yes,
sir.
Okay, slow down before you get there so you don't have to cram it in reverse. Swing the back end toward the point. Turn hard left.
Well, yeah, what?
Hard left. Okay, now come back here. Put it in neutral and come back. Reverse it. Reverse it. Reverse it.
George's got his fighting belt on, ready to catch the second cobia, hopefully, unless the cootie gets it first. There's George holding the bait.
Set the hook. Harder.
Okay, now fight it. I got the video. I got it. I've been running.
That's the biggest one I've seen.
I've been running it since before he even hooked it. Is he fighting hard, Georgie?
Yeah.
All right. Just fight him like a regular. Just fight him like a regular fish. You don't want to break the line.
You don't want to. Yeah, get him. Don't worry, he's right here.
You don't want to break the line, Georgie.
No, not yet. I'm not bringing him this green. He's bigger than the one I caught. Whoa, the beauty.
Is he jumping?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. We're going to mount that baby. You dropped that rod. That's about $1,000 worth of rod. I'm going to have to jump in after it, cooties and all. That's a beauty. Get this ready.
Yeah, the only thing I'm worried about is the line breaking.
No, the line ain't gonna break.
There's no leader on there, Georgie.
No, I'm not ready.
That's a nice, nice sized fish.
He's looking here like that. He's gonna make a mess.
Whoa.
Look.
You want me to open up the cooler?
Honey, put the camera down.
You want me to open up the cooler?
Yeah.
And that's awesome.
Awesome.
All right.
That's jam, man.
Wait, the Richards. Holy shit, look at the size of them.
Let me see.
That's jam.
All right, Georgie.
Secret
way to
bait.
Go. Way to go. Way to go.
Hey, yeah. Before we go home tomorrow, let's come over here. Free Tacopia.
Piss on me!
I'm gonna erase all that. Honey.
Oh, hey. I don't. She's zooming and she's gotta zoom in to see it.
Hey, I'm gonna erase all that. Look at her laugh. Alright.
Pissed on me.
You gonna take a shower, honey?
Get the fucking camera on.
You know, I keep forgetting that,
yeah, she's got that camera.
My crap.
Here's John. Woo, nice one, John. Oh, yeah, you're on candid camera. What's George doing? Hey, you, Grouch, Mr. Grouch.
Get inside.
Huh? Let's see how the film looks this time of night.
Put the backlight.
It's having a hard time focusing, I think.
Put the backlight.
The focus keeps kind of.
I don't want to go in that water.
Going on and off, but that looks like Larry Butler out there.
I don't want to
run to the ground.
Dad, get your head out of the way. There's Greg, Larry, and Wesley pushing the boat. I know it's a little blurry.
Somebody's pulling.
Yeah, look at all the people there.
I didn't think they'd take a rope after those, Artie.
Hey, there's four people there.
Somebody must have walked in from Artie's boat.
Here we are at Marquesas. Larry pushing the boat. Greg and Wesley.
I've seen a hammerhead come by here. It's 14 foot long.
Greg probably told him where to go.
They're looking to eat something.
I'll bet two. I'll bet two. Yeah.
Two? Yeah. Courtney?
Huh?
Are you going to do anything?
Two? I don't have any money.
Notice who the big winner is.
I'll bet two.
Oh, John, all right. Who's I got side two. Here?
Right. Yeah, I'll bet two.
I guess I got three kings.
All right, what's more?
Ain't good enough. Go? Might as well put them away.
I got two pairs.
Ain't good enough. Put them away. Oh.
What's the boat? You don't. Why are you clearing your hands?
You know? No, everybody bet, didn't they?
Okay.
Everybody
bet.
Yeah,
everybody bet, didn't they?
Three aces. Oh, you beat me.
Three aces.
Thank you.
There's Larry's boat. They're still on the sandbar. The last day of our trip.
turns Larry's boat high and dry. We're gonna try to pull him out now. Well, here goes John and George.
My dad's gonna fall in.
George, you bumped into me. They're on their rescue mission for, sorry about that, but the camera keeps slipping in my hand. Kind of windy today. Here's the rescue mission again. See what these guys are up to. Evaluating the situation to see which way we're going to pull the boats. Which way we're going to pull the boat out. He's high and dry in about 4 inches of water. That's as close as I can zoom in. They trying to do to that boat? Let's see. These guys, oh my god, what are they doing? They're pushing them. John and George. What's Greg doing on the other side?
Where's the button? It'll be 10,000 on video.
Yeah. Maybe this will be the funniest video.
Hey man, it's worth 10,000 bucks.
Look at that thing on the rock, on the sandbar. Look at them walking over there. Look at Wesley with his boots on. Larry and Wes gonna make it? Come on, Larry and Wes, are you gonna come or not? I'm not sure. I'm not sure the coffee's gonna be worth it. Come on, boys.
More than a football field? I don't
think so.
Hold it there,
George. You gotta get broke.
There's Artie.
Hi, Greg. You're on candid camera. Did you brush your teeth today? Smile! Mm-hmm. Now he's on candid camera.
How are you doing,
Paul?
Huh?
Here come the heroes.
front, dude. They'll suck right up.
It's not that bad, but
I stepped on a
shoes are gonna be better.
What's the plan, guys?
You need to put some gas in the dinghy. Did you put gas?
Oh. Yeah, I put gas. I filled it up this morning.
You gonna make a bridle?
Yeah. You got one of your heavy duty dock lines? My dock lines.
Here, I'll get one. Uncle John has better heavy duty dock lines.
What's the plan, George? You gonna take them out with the boats?
George, you go to the bow.
Oh, I
got. Go to the bow.
Pull the boat with all these people. I think we'll do it. We already got it off the high part.
Here comes Artie.
But it was high. I mean, it was on a mound.
To add to the manpower.
Yeah, we were there yesterday.
Well, they so moved.
They moved the tents in. They can all get off. Last night.
And push the boat off. That seems to be the plan.
George,
what do you want me to do? You want to
everybody, put shoes on. You got shoes? Put shoes on, and we're coming on a dinghy over there. We're gonna push. Yeah, those are good. Carol?
Yeah.
You stay on this boat.
Okay.
Evan, get on my boat. We'll go on the dinghy. Georgie, you standing by with that line? Okay, don't let go yet. Wait till it's down.
There's Larry. Whoops, sorry. Camera keeps slipping on my hand. There's Larry pretending like. I mean, not to be pissed off at Greg. Yeah. What happened to Artie? Did he get stuck? Sure, that's a four-man dinghy? Find out. I got the camera nice and steady in my hand now. We're gonna get behind the boat and push. And then we've got John standing by. He's gonna pull him out with his boat. Thank you.
John, you hear me?
Yeah, go ahead.
Okay, we got communication.
I just said wave when you're ready, that way.
Yeah, we'll shout when we're ready.
Kind of filming under the sun here, so I'm not sure.
Okay, I'm getting ready.
Okay, here we are. This is the Marquesas. Oh yes, they're doing it. They got it. They got it, man. They got it. All right. Yes.
Hey, 11 horsepower motor.
How do you feel, Larry?
And you got it all on film.
Hey! We did it! Woo! Woo! Yes! John pulled him out, yes.
Catch a big grouper with this one.
Carol.
Okay, I'm trying to polarize lens, see if it makes any difference. Here's with it. Here's without it.
Now you see it?
Here we are at Boca Grande. Everybody's on the beach. We're on our way back to the ramp. This is about halfway to Key West. Bahamian Defense Force.
Lots of jack out here, George.
What?
What do you got? Oh, we got ice.
Oh, yeah.
He's just going to the bathroom.
The anchor, or they got a line off the bows.
Look, it's steaming up.
It's going up further.
Oh, oh shit.
It's actually going up higher.
Yeah, it
you
is.
See the bow raise up? The bow raise up?
Yeah, give him more gas. Give him more gas.
Damn it.
Oh, man. And bonefish.
Is that the bonefish, Rudy?
The bonefish.
Here we are, changing the prop. Spun the head.
Snap a head.
Sounds like you ran aground when that hub spins.
Here comes the DA.
Back here.
Really?
No.
That's what it sounded like, and then I realized it was the hub.
I didn't run aground.
Just bonefish Greg.
Of course, Larry was right behind us. He would have hit it too.
I thought they kind of go. I heard something go.
I didn't think Larry saw us either. He kept coming.
Thank you.
my football. Oh,
yeah. 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 You like the
hey, get my football.
Like blue football.
Hey,
get
my football.
Merry Christmas. Ryan, is
he's
there
gorgeous,
Ryan
isn't he?
He's right. Oh my goodness, yeah, are you Mr. Ryan? Wow. Hey, all right. Oh, oh, oh. I need some more presents, helper.
That's Mary Alice. Christopher! This is from the boat.
Oh, Christopher, is it a Christopher? Are you Christopher?
Here.
Do you have some ID?
Here, this is from
oh, I think I remember you from your letter. Yes,
Mary
thank
Alice.
You. I do.
Another one for you?
Oh.
Good idea.
Come
in. No tag.
Oh.
This is the first.
Oh, is there a Tyler in the house? Yes, Tyler! Well, I do believe this is a special gift. This from Chris and Kelly.
This is for Kelly.
For Kelly? Why, Kelly's here. There she is.
What you got? A shoe
yes.
This is for Kelly for her birthday.
Oh, well, I don't do birthdays. I'm saying I'm happy Christmas.
Oh, oh, oh.
She likes it.
Oh,
she likes it.
I know that you want something for your boat, no doubt. An autopilot. That's what you want for Christmas. An autopilot. Yes, Santa makes those. A bad old boat. Autopilot.
Okay, watch the hands.
How else do you think
that you get away with murder?
That's the way you get away with murder, being
killed.
Oh, oh, it's a gas pump.
Did pop. You
sell Santa Pop yet?
She said
something.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Oh, yeah,
yeah, yeah, yeah.
Mine. Mine,
okay.
It's your car.
Okay, let's see here. What do I have? Oh, for Tyler. I have for Tyler. Tyler.
Tyler.
Where's Tyler?
Tyler.
Tyler, where are you? Oh, here's Tyler. Tyler, you know that dump truck you were asking Santa for? I think you might find her out there in that car. Kelly, we have for Kelly.
Mom, Larry. Okay, and then
it's
for Ryan.
Okay, I have. Oh, let's see who this is. That's for Kelly.
Ryan.
Oh, we have for Ryan from Chris and Kelly. Yes, 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 yes.
Really good. Let me open one of mine.
Such nice children.
Oh, how cute.
Yes. Santa's reindeer are waiting outside. I'm gonna have to go out and feed them some hay soon. Yes, please. And some rum.
And some rum.
Bye, Santa.
Bye, Santa.
Bye. George the second.
Well, we have George that's 1, you, George 2, and George... No, he's George 3.
Carol and the Three Georges.
Oh, my gosh. Carol and the Three Georges. Carol and the Three Stooges.
That. Where are you going, Richard?
Sandy.
Good
boy, George.
I know. John from Grandpa... Oh, I'll save
this. We'll keep that.
Put on top of the TV.
I'll pocket his.
Robert.
Look at that stuck envelope.
Richard.
Richard.
Went outside.
Went outside.
Sandy,
you see
these shoes?
How he's got.
Connie.
But he does like Robert, though. The back of the shoe, he wears it halfway in and it clinks down.
I'm telling you, I'm going to North Carolina next summer and I'm buying
North Carolina, heck, I heard of another place. I'm going right after Christmas. Boaz, in Alabama. All outlets in one location, in one shopping center. It goes for miles.
Well, I have one of those in green.
I'm flying in there.
Greensboro. With my Christmas money.
Oh, they're from Allison?
Yeah.
Not that, it's just I.
Why don't you take a boat?
No, they can go to the woods. I've been to the woods a lot this week.
You're ready for the boat.
Oh,
that's great. You're ready for some real action.
And that's all I use is a gentleman.
There's going to be a lot of people and everything. I would like to go.
Cool.
Get a close up for Richard's nose.
Are you leaving?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, we got to get it.
We just figured there's no way, guys, that we can get you what you want. So this way.
See your nose, Richard.
No fun. I'm saving money to buy something. I have $300 and I'm going to go buy it.
Aren't you saving toward a bracelet or something?
I'm saving toward a bracelet and if I have money left over.
Thank you, Uncle George.
Let's put a date up. Oh, jeez.
You ain't touching my money.
You didn't have to remind me.
Oh, did we get...
You got your calendars, one for here and one for there.
Something
like
being bold
and telling you what I want.
Yes, let's go.
All these are for Grandpa?
The clothes for me.
The clothes are Grandpa's off.
Come here, Santa.
You got the clothes.
Oh, good. Get Scott like that.
This is the good one.
Your nice side.
Richard.
What?
I'll write to Laura to see Andrew. I'm sure you went shopping.
What is it?
Yeah, that's
what I think.
You're
like
that.
It's
the
new
hey,
person
around
like that.
Oh,
it's
the new person.
Your dad.
Your dad
would do it.
Cheese, your
age.
Carol.
No.
Here I am, Ann's house.
7:24. I like the way you have it. 7:48
in the morning. Here we are getting ready to depart for Bimini. Right on time. It should have departed at noon. Let's see what time. Hey, 6 minutes off. Got the three red boats getting ready to depart. We just ate lunch. There's K-Days, Carol and Georgie. There's Migration. And way in the back is our days with John Jr. and John Sr. getting ready for Dolphin. The blue boat didn't make it, and Weaver didn't make it either. Weaver had to go shoot ducks, and Richard had to go hunting. Oh well, we know who the true voters are. Okay. Talk to you all in Bimini. Channel Mass and Hammock. We're leaving at 12:18. Let's see if we get there in 3 hours. About 3:18. Over and out.
Something wrong when you're coming.
Bimini in December. That's the Bimini Inn Hotel. Got a beauty?
I did all of my embarkation thing. As much as I can.
Okay. That's migration up there. Place looks empty.
I guess I got
you got your ears on?
What'd you say?
Yeah, go ahead. Just call up there to check in or what?
Yeah,
Okay.
That is Bimini. That's North Bimini here.
What's up,
got
Dad?
Georgie, did you put the yellow flag on for me? I'll give it to you.
Here they are, the girls. Here's the girls.
Film that guy right there, that guy Scullin. That black guy in that little boat there.
He's not Scullin anymore, he'd be rowing.
We're gonna let a lot of line out.
Drop the hook.
When can we stop moving forward?
Look at that guy on that little boat, how he rows.
Oh, I see how yours. did you tell John what happened?
I think he was there.
For Joy's nap? Oh, that's right.
Poor little Paula. Oh no, it's broken. Is this?
Well, Dad.
Break loose. Bimini big game. I can't see you. You're too dark.
Can you see me?
No, you're
it's just too
dark.
Dark. Let me get in here in the light. Partying, Bimini.
Yep.
December 27th.
Yeah, I got the date on that. There's a Christmas boat coming in the harbor I was trying to get. There he is, right there. Coming this way.
Tide is almost slack.
our Weech's dock. Saturday morning. The weather turned out to be nice after all. I don't know if it's going to stay that way, but there's Hank working hard. And there's the boatman's. What's for breakfast? Eggs and bimini toast?
Thank you for the bimini toast, George.
Oh, you're welcome. Where's Lester?
Shopping with Pat at the Bimini Mall.
All the boats there are parked waiting for customs. See if they got a yellow flag on. I can't see yellow here, but that's a customs building. This is Jerry. There's my buddy. Smile, Jerry. You're on candid camera. That's Rick's boat. Rick Bryce. Across the way is Brown's dock. John doing reading something.
Well, here we are in beautiful Bimini. The day today is kind of overcast, sprinkling. We're at the fuel docks right now, getting gassing up, and we just got our rum right over there somewhere, I believe it was. Finishing up on the fuel. This is the harbor inside Bimini. Can't really appreciate the colors of the water right now, but it's beautiful. Here are the girls coming back. Let's see what they're up to. Oh, really?
They're going to change their name to the Liquorman's.
Is that what you're up to? Are you shopping again?
Yes. Trying to get your husband to buy you a shirt like this, but it's got neat fish on
oh,
it.
Oh, how nice.
She's already got one, he says.
Oh, you're kidding. That little cheapskate.
$12. I said, $12, George. Put it on your charge.
Is that right? He doesn't have $12?
He did buy you something. He's getting it autographed.
Oh, is that right?
Yeah.
Well, what is it?
It's,
All right. Bye for now.
I don't know how much it cost. Ma'am, how much did that thing cost before you saw it?
Huh? How much?
$2.10.
Another?
No, $210.
Oh. A lot of money he spent on you.
Is that for... Here we are at Honeymoon Harbor. There's Georgie. Queen and Conk for his mommy for her birthday. Yeah. Look at Georgie's eyes.
What is it, a ziplock?
I'm zooming in on this.
I'm coming, sweetie.
Charter boat. Looks like they got a lot of people on board.
Huh. Is this safe here, do you think?
Yeah.
I'm leaving.
A cam comes over.
There's John. Hey, hey, watch your camera.
Watch out.
Yeah. Here we are in Honeymoon Harbor. Our last day in Bimini. These are kind of rough. Hey, Georgie. How are you doing there, partner? Yeah, Georgie just got up.
Wow.
Oh, you're not doing too well.
There's French toast.
It's cooking. See, what's John and John doing? What's Pat doing down there, John?
Oh, she's sleeping.
Oh, my goodness. I never seen Pat sleep this late. What time is it? 9:36. What happened, Pat? And you had the air conditioner on last night. Huh? Taking a nap? Oops. Yeah? Oh, my goodness. Boatmans are all up. Done drank all the coffee. Yeah, it's ready now. If you guys want some more, here's the beautiful Honeymoon Harbor. We had a bonfire there last night. Yeah, some crazy guys. Girls. This is the harbor.
Three red boats, once again, in Gun Cay, Bahamas, December 29th, almost the end of the year. I'd like to stay here another 3 or 4 days. The weather is blowing a little bit this morning. We're heading back in about 2 or 3 hours. And the seas should be kind of rough because they're going to be coming right into us as we head back to Miami. It's the Honeymoon Harbor, Half Moon Harbor. It's a little cove and should be protected from southeast to southwest winds. And last night it was just that, but it switched in the middle of the night and it caught us by surprise about 5 in the morning. Started coming out of the north. Neighbors. There's an old hull that's upside down over there. We were going to take it and make a lobster reef out of it in the bank somewhere, but it looks kind of heavy to pull off, especially with this north wind heading in. Last night we had a bonfire. That's the remains of it. There's Captain Jensen. Went for a morning run. Yeah, I always got to do the paperwork.
Roll of toilet paper I found over there.
Because his steering is bad, George. Well, Greg will be at the dock waiting for us. Let me see if I can zoom in on him. We're betting that he is going to be at the dock. Looks like him on the end. Yeah, that's Greg. That looks like him right there.
Need a
that?
That's called a mechanic.
What? That's... Now what should I do in the interim right now? Will you run? Should I go right there?
Enjoy the show and wish to make a contribution. Please don't feel bashful. Please feel free to do so. Your contribution will be greatly appreciated. Thank you.
Thank you.
been there 2 to 3 months that people before start noticing what you're doing. It'll begin with problems. You know, we don't do good jobs. And show me he's not going to get me. But you'll find that after a month or so, but in doing this, it shows me where his sadness and his life hurt. Because he's very good for it. But he also loves that challenge, which again draws him to change people. But he loves a challenge, and all his life he's going to be very, very competitive. In basis, it will help him.
And that will be your cue to let me know.
Love will come. You can always tell that you talk like that.
Remember, if you see something you like, clap quick. I ain't doing it long. Sit down! Thanks to all five of you. Give me a break, will ya? Hey, you guys, while I'm defying death, could you give it up a little more enthusiastically? Tough crowd, huh? Okay, see if you can guess where the applause cue is yourself on this one. Okay, Don, come Come on out here where I can see you. Stand on the ledge or next to it or something. Right there, perfect. Okay, where's the person with the net? The nut with the net. Stick it out. Okay, ready, guy? When I say go, one ball. Ready, go. Good, hold it. Ready, go. Good, net, nut. He got it?
No.
Nobody's ever got two in a row. Ready, go. Make some noise for him, boom. Okay, have a seat there. Can you hear me?
Yeah!
The high wire!
Yeah!
The sunset!
Yeah!
The juggler!
Yeah!
Five balls!
Oh, tough back to follow.
Did one go in?
Get the net.
Did it go in?
Yeah.
Oh shit, where's the nut with the net? Get over there. Get over there. What do you think the net's for, dumbbell? Hey, buddy, get over there. Are they floating away?
I'm going to reach it if I want to.
Somebody reach him. Hey, Don, can you hear me?
Yeah.
Would you stand up where you were?
He's
you got
getting
two
it.
Pins?
Yeah.
Okay. He's got it.
Back up close so I can see you. Good. When I say go, lock me a pin, fat head up, no spin. Ready? Go. Good. Hold it.
No spin.
Somebody? Ready? Go. Right. Got the apple?
Yeah.
Go. Yes! You got him?
Yeah.
All right! Make some noise for my crew!
All right!
Yeah, just leave him right down there, thanks. Last one, deep breath.
Oh!
Woo! Is that enough? Tonight, give him a smile and some respect. My name is Will. My wife and 13 children appreciate it. Any and all donations? Thanks. Yo!
We excellent each other. Thanks, everyone.
Thanks. Thanks, sir.
Thank you.
call out the boys that I've seen here tonight this evening with us, Neil and Sarah. Young with them, so most of them 6th and 7th grade, and it's a great opportunity because I get to spend 6 or 7 years, sometimes before that, if I get them on a club team outside of the lake. I just recently we had a boy graduate last year, sat out of years, his name's Mike Clover. He was going to be looking trials for us, and he got 12th, and he was on Stanford on a full scholarship. We've had many young men come through the program and get that kind of a title and move along in the same way, but they have to start somewhere, and the junior high school team is where we get them going. These boys don't just train 3 months, they train most of them year-round, and believe it or not, some of them get up at 4:30 in the morning and go to practice before they go to school, and then they come and do it again in the afternoon. It's a very dedicated life, and I give a lot of hard work to do all the time. Anyway, you develop such a rapport with them that you watch them grow up, you watch them go off to school, and it's very meaningful when you see them graduate with some honors. Our big goal every year is to win the Dade County Junior High School Championships, mostly because we're a small school and we get to go up against all the large schools Dade County-wide, not just private schools, I'm talking about all the public schools. And we've won this meet now 3-4 years in a row, and now these gentlemen are starting to trickle up into the senior high ranks. And we've been runner-up to Columbus a couple of times in the past. We actually beat them this year, but we got disqualified in a relay. But that's kind of things that happen. If you look at the program, you'll see little asterisks next to some of the names. That's boys that competed at the Dade County Youth Fair meet and scored in the top 8. Our lettermen. Anyone got a letter, that means they went to our district championships, which is senior high school championships, and they scored in the top 6 and probably qualified for the state championships. And that's a pretty big routine to go through and make at such a young age. Since in our state of Florida, we're right ranked to number 5 in the country in state meets in that manner. And most of the kids that graduate and get through the program usually go off to school with some type of award, scholastic leave, to a major university. That's one of our goals also. But through the years, we get to watch this happen over and over again. My most improved gentleman isn't with us this evening. I know we're in the middle of our exams right now, but things like that happen. Manny Casanas isn't here with us, but a little story on him. He just did begin the season with us. Came out as an 8th grader. And he learned a stroke called butterfly, some of you see it on television. And he trained about 2.5 months. He took the Dade County Youth Fair meet, and he scored in the top 3 at that meet, that event. And it's a very, very exciting thing to see him do. And on the other hand, we have a gentleman for most valuable performance on the team. But leading up to him is a few other boys like Fernando Diaz, Sarah. Those boys got their first letters and second letters, meaning they scored at the district meet, top 6, and almost made themselves an honorary spot going to our state championships. It's tough, hard work with these kids, and by the time you bring them to that level, they're competitive, and a year ago, Michael won a state championship, and first time in Valence history you've done anything like that also. Most valuable summer. We asked this guy to not swim the Dade County Junior High Youth Fair meet because we told them we could win the championships of Dade County on the senior high level if he would come up and take this on as a challenge. And he thought about it, and lo and behold, he took down the 500 freestyle, which is 20 lengths of the pool. He did a really great job. He snuck in there. I think he got 5th place in the event, which was really good enough points for us to win the meet. And if we haven't had a DQ in the relay, we would beat Columbus with all their talent. And we really ask a lot of him and expect a lot of great things for him in the future since he's only going to be a sophomore next year. George LeBert, please come forward. Yay! sixth grade boys here. Jim Carlos Magnani moves the view. They decided that they were sticking out for their hard work this year, and we'll look for them next year also. Being at Belen and the amount of work that these kids are made to do through their academics, it really separates them from the rest of the crowd on what they have to do in school also. I require a lot of them. I demand a lot from them. Discipline is a very big thing on my schedule, and it'll show up in years to come. And the school support is tremendous. I thank Coach Barkeem and the coaching staff. They're very supportive to us, and I hope to do a big job in the future. Good night, gentlemen. Thank you.